bill terms. This must be juxtaposed on the position that one is innocent until proven guilty. Therefore, Your Honor, we believe that in your, as you exercise your discretion, please bear in mind that the bail term should not be such that the accused will have been, will find themselves in a situation where they are being punished in the interim when they are innocent and their guilty has not been proven by anybody. The last thing I would like to say is that, Your Honor, you please put into consideration also the fact that most of the KVDA staff, especially in case number 18 and 19, are very junior employees, and they earn very meager amount, and they are basically not going to, please don't treat them like any other person. Don't generalize, that's what I'm trying to say, don't generalize their situation, because they, some of them are really, really very junior staff in the parastatal itself. And the last thing I'd like to say is that not everybody is facing the same charges, Your Honor. For example, the accused number 3 is only her name is only indicated in case number 20, P.S. Susan Courage. She's been there only for, served public for less than one and a half years. And interestingly, Your Honor, she came into the ministry in March 2018. The period that is that the DPP is investigating for planning and procurement is from 2014 to September 2018. So if you look at the period she's been in the ministry and regarding the accusations, it's only 6 months. The DPP never bothered to think about who was the PS from 2014, who was the cabinet secretary from 2014 to the period. So you can realize, Your Honor, for that short stint period, and for the short period she served in public service, it would be unfair to generalize the bail terms for someone who has served very short stint in public service. The last thing I'd like to say is that if you look at all these accused, from the accused number 1, number 2, number 3, to the last, they have diligently served the public. They've given many hours, just like yourself, Your Honor, many, many hours to public service. Then, just one day, we think that, you know, it's not possible, Your Honor, after putting such period of time on public service, for any person who has served the public to say that one is a flight risk, or to say that they are not patriotic enough and they love their country. What is ladies and gentlemen are up to is to be afforded the opportunity to prove their innocence, and they are very eager to